The blood, as we all know, have many different functions in the body. Most of them includes transportation of different nutrients including oxygen, glucose, and enzymes. It also functions for protection, temperature, and pH balance. But have you ever wondered what really composes our blood? Generally, we can divide the blood into two main groups. The first one is called the plasma. It fills the 55% of the total blood volume. It is the liquid component of the blood and it has no cellular content. The other 45% is the blood cellular component, and it is divided into three different kinds of cells. The greatest portion goes to the red blood cells at 80%, and the remaining 20% is shared by the white blood cells and the platelets. The red blood cells contains a protein called hemoglobin, which is responsible for its characteristic red color and the ability to carry oxygen atoms. It fills the bulk of 75-85% RBC count. The white blood cells, however, is much fewer compared to the red blood cells, and only comprises at about 6% of the cellular component. These cells are further divided to 5 different cells, namely neutrophils, being the most abundant of all, which covers about 60%, lymphocytes being the second most numerous, the monocytes, eosinophils, and lastly, the basophils. And the last but not the least, the platelets, which is the main responsible for the blood clotting process. The plasma, moreover, is also composed of different compounds. These are the water, being the largest at about 90%, the protein, which consists of the albumin, the clotting factors, and immunoglobulins at around 8%, the hormones, which includes amines and steroids, and then salts and minerals, that is about 2% of the plasma volume. But these measurements are, of course, varies from species to species. Now, the importance of knowing the normal components of the blood is very helpful in detecting diseases or disorders in the cheapest way possible. With just a drop of blood, a machine, and a basic knowledge in hematology and clinical pathology, any deviations seen on the normal values can indicate many other signs of abnormalities occurring in our body. So you want more curious videos? Please hit the like and subscribe button now. And please do check our Facebook page, Google+, and Twitter account.